1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Welcome to the channel. While you are here today, I have two warnings for you. One is a new one. Don't run with knives. And of course, as always, beware of the pits.
Here's another challenge that came my way. Thanks to Scout Crafter. He bought a quantity of these Echo knife blades. As you see from the price, the original was $1.59. And as he explained, this was either 1950s or 1960s vintage, and he bought a few of them and sent me one to make into a knife. Of course, it needs a handle. I've got an Echo knife that's about this same age. I inherited from my mother, and she had it for I don't know how long. I just remember it forever being around, and I still use it today. And that is a great knife and a beautiful edge on it. Even though they're made today, I don't know if they're making them the same way they used to. Stainless, vanadium, and these are great cutting knives. So I've got to come up with a handle for it. So I looked at a lot of options trying to come up with a knife handle for this. And I looked at all the kitchen knives I owned. I looked online at handle designs. I looked at the beautiful handle that Magdad, 357 Magdad made, which really turned out nice. Then I looked at the unusual handle that Hand Tool Restoration did. And of course his was using an antler. That turned out really unique. And I said, well, I got to do something different. I'm not going to do just a traditional knife handle. So I came up with another idea. Why not make this knife look more like a tool? And since we're in the tool business and not so much, you know, hybrid knife and tool. So I came up with this idea. This old handle that I had used on a couple of tools. And I took it and decided to try it out as a handle for this knife. First thing I did was took it apart, sanded it down quite a bit. It's quite a bit smaller now. The grip was okay. It was just large. And of course, this handle now would be a handle that you would see on a screwdriver or on a wrench. And we're going to adapt it to this knife blade. And what I had, I actually took a carriage bolt that was the approximate right size and sanded it and smoothed it, gave it that chrome look, and installed it in the back end here using my hot glue gun. Put a little stop down in here to stop the glue from going through where, and filled it with the hot glue and installed this in there. That turned out nice. And the next thing I did, had to come up with a method for installing this into this handle. So I tried a little different types of materials and came up with this contraption here. But basically it's a hex nut that I grooved inside. Actually took used this square file inside the hex nut to cut a couple of grooves in it, upper and lower, so I could fit it up very tightly on this shank. I kept doing it and doing it till it was just really a precise fit, and then I hammered this on here, and it's really snug by itself. And of course, that's not going to be enough to secure it in here where there's no wobble. So I came up with these additional wood pieces here. Now I'll put some glue in here, even though it's a very, very tight fit without the glue, where it'll stabilize it steady. And once the nut gets in here, it'll really center it and position it, and then we'll have a completed item. So I'll go ahead now and install the handle. Well, here we are. The tool handle is installed on the knife blade, and got a nice finished item here. I'm really glad I went with the tool look on this. This handle I had used before on a couple of tools and never really liked it. One thing was I didn't really like the color of it. So I completely stripped this down and then sanded it down quite a bit because it was a little large around for a knife handle. And just for the end of it here, I think I showed you where I took this carriage bolt and sanded the end down and shined it and installed it in here. Put a little block down in here, filled it with hot glue, and installed this, which was a lot easier than using mixing epoxy and putting it in there. And the hot glue works pretty good, and it's very strong. It's a strong glue. Again, once it's installed, it worked great, looks great. I like the way I got the blade exactly centered the way it should be. And as far as the appearance, of course, you can see how that wonderful handle works. That's a handle that could be on a screwdriver or a wrench or any other kind of tool. But in this case, it's on my kitchen knife. And I'm really tickled to get this because I have one of these Echo knives from Echo knives from a long time ago. Came from my mother, and it's about 50 years old. It still cuts. It still does a decent job, but it's starting to get dull, and it would be, I don't know how you sharpen these. So I've got a brand new blade that was made back probably during the 50s when real quality vanadium stainless blade. And I wanted to thank Scout Crafter so much for sending me this blade and making me a part of putting, you know, this challenge together. And again, instead, you know, I saw the different handles. Magdad made one out of just a beautiful handle that looked like an original handle that belonged on a knife. Jim, from England, Hand Tool Restoration, made a handle out of a antler, and it was really unique and nice, really nice. And of course, I wanted to do something different, and that's when I came up with the idea of making a tool handle for the knife. And it feels good in hand, and I know this will cut extremely well. It's super sharp and nice, and of course, I've got a lot of experience with this type blade, so I know how it works. So I'll be glad to have this one in my kitchen now to take the place of that one that's not cutting so well now after 50 years. And again, thanks for getting me involved and making me a part of this challenge. I'm very, very pleased with the finished result. And I hope that you enjoyed the video and enjoyed seeing something a little different. Thanks for watching.